And over the last 25 years, you know, I've encountered many patient stories and their journeys. What I do is I share two of them and how those stories have inspired me to do what we are doing for society today. This is the story of this lady called Gayatri. And Gayatri came to me maybe about 20 years ago for a routine health checkup. She and her sister both just came for a regular health checkup. And you know, while looking at her slides at that time under the microscope, the same microscope that I showed you, I found out that her blood count extremely low, but yet she had evidence of blood cancer. So I called up Gayatri and I said, Gayatri, I need you to come back and I need to collect a second sample. I want to confirm my diagnosis. So she came back in the afternoon, I collected the second sample, I rechecked it and it confirmed that she has blood cancer. So I called Gayatri and her husband in the evening and I said that, look, you have blood cancer, but I've also arranged an appointment with a hematologist at a large hospital. The hematologist, fortunately, had a colleague who was a bone marrow transplant expert in CMC Vellore. This patient took my advice, went and saw the hematologist, who in turn recommended this patient to go get a bone marrow transplant. They could afford it at that time. Today, after 20 years, Gayatri is cured of acute leukemia, which otherwise has a life expectancy of only a few weeks. So the bottom line here is, the best treatment for cancer is prevention. The next best is early detection. The second story is about this boy, Abhay. Abhay and I have, you know, we have an amazing bond. Abhay was just 8 years old when he started Salogan. And he used to come for his blood tests on his own. Can you imagine an 8-year-old boy coming for his blood tests on his own? And he would come and tell me, Doctor, check my hemoglobin. And I would wonder, I mean, what is this kid? I mean, this amazing child who's coming all by himself, not accompanied by his parents. Once in a while, his nanny would accompany him. And I realized that, you know, why is he so daring, so brave, so strong? It's only because he's been used to needles all his life. Abhay has a condition called thalassemia major. Now, thalassemia major requires you to have blood transfusion every 21 days. And before blood transfusion, they have to go and get a hemoglobin check to see if the hemoglobin is low enough, which they can go and show to the blood bank, and the blood bank will issue them a bottle. Now, Abhay has been taking blood transfusions all his life. He must have undertaken over 500 blood transfusions. Now, the complications of thalassemia is not the blood transfusion, but it is the iron overload because of excessive blood transfusion and the iron that gets deposited in every organ of your body. So you have to actually remove that excessive iron through medication or through a pump. And he's having to do this all his life. Now he is continuously, that's why we have him with boxing gloves. He is, and so Abhay and Gayatri featured in our diary that we have at Suburban Diagnostics. When we completed 20 years, we featured 20 lives that have been part of our journey for the last 20 years. And of course, next year in July, when we complete 25, we hope to do something even bigger and better to showcasing what we have been able to, you know, how patients have been able to inspire and influence us. And Abhay's story influences us that genetic conditions like thalassemia are still unfortunately lesser known in our country. The awareness of genetic diseases is so low that people, before they get married, only match their horoscopes. If only they match their thalassemia or genetic status, if we stop doing just 36 gun mila liye, but if we do just a simple 800 rupee test of matching the thalassemia status, conditions like thalassemia major can actually be prevented. Countries like Cyprus have actually done that, where they've made thalassemia screening mandatory for every couple. So I want, if our government can, you know, not issue a marriage certificate unless they do a basic hemoglobin check. So we issue a marriage certificate only after they do a basic thalassemia screening test. At least they are aware that both the couple have thalassemia minor and they can take the necessary action to prevent thalassemia major and conditions like this from happening. This is such a huge burden on Abhay as an individual, such a huge burden on his family, such a huge burden on society. Imagine if, you know, the amount of blood that is required for these conditions was not actually, you could actually give blood when it was genuinely required. Today we have a shortage of 3 million bottles of blood annually. And imagine if the blood could be used more productive. So the whole impact, the whole burden on individual, on the family and on the society. And that is what we want to do is, both these stories, you know, they talk about the importance of early detection and prevention. You know, and it is our endeavor that through early detection and prevention, how can we reduce the burden on the individual, on the family and on society. This is what we call at Suburban Diagnostics, unburden your health or unburden healthcare. The idea is that you pick up diseases at a stage where they are either reversible or preventable and you reduce the healthcare burden. And imagine if these same trends were applied, the same trends of proactiveness were applied across the entire country. Imagine the extent to which it could lighten the load of diseases in our healthcare system. You know, today, healthcare in India, as I mentioned, is extremely reactive because it is out of pocket. You go to a doctor only when you fall ill. I want to change that life cycle. Go to a doctor to remain healthy. Don't do a test only when you fall ill. Do a test not to fall ill. That's the new change that we want to bring. You know, like in the West, our diseases are also becoming more chronic. Almost 2/3 of our disease burden is chronic, yet we have less than one doctor for 1,000 population. We have an increasing aging population, yet we have less than one hospital bed. You know, we have not enough public funding. We have a very increasingly demanding middle class, but we don't have enough skills, you know, to match that demand. We have the government who wants to do this Ayushman Bharat. Will they be able to implement it because there is not enough skilled manpower in healthcare to be able to deliver that? So these are all the challenges that we have today. So what can we do in this era of constraint? How can we do more with less? I believe healthcare today is becoming increasingly transactional. It is all of us in this room who need to change that. We need to continue to remain relevant to our target audience, which is our patients and our doctors. We need to remain relevant to them by using modern technologies like genetic disease, by genetic testing or by molecular diagnostics to be able to pick up conditions at a stage where they can be either prevented or reversed. The idea is to treat more in the OPD so that only those genuine cases that need to be treated in the IPD can be treated. I'm sure all of you must have faced this, that when you want to take an appointment with some very senior doctor in some large hospital, you are asked to wait for a week, sometimes even months to get that hospital appointment. It's because the doctor is overburdened with things which he or she should not be overburdened with. So it is our endeavor to see, to work with all of you to bring down this healthcare burden. You know, we buy insurance for ourselves. You know, we buy this life insurance thinking that this is the best security we can give our family. I believe the best security we can give our family is our good health. There is no substitute, no insurance can substitute the insurance of good health for your family. So what I do every year is, on my birthday, I gift myself a health checkup. I do a health checkup every year on my birthday, and I'm competitive with myself to make sure that each year my health checkup is better than the previous year. While I have insurance, that's okay, but I want to make sure that my family does not use the insurance after I die and I'm actually present to be able to enjoy my life with them and give them that security of my presence. So I want to make sure that each of you, how are you going to celebrate your birthday? Is it going to be a healthy way or, you know, going and getting drunk? So remember, guys, you know, think of it, just look at the points on the slide and think, how can you be different? What can you do differently? How can you stand out from the crowd? If I am here today, I'm sure all of you can be. I'm looking forward to seeing you here and being in the audience. I want to come and listen to your success stories very soon. Thank you very much. Thank you.